Craving for melt-in-your-mouth Wagyu beef? Here's a place in Makati that serves just that. Yokohama Meat Kitchen may be the new kid on the block, but it's been gaining loyal patrons for the high-quality meats they offer in a space that is both posh and comfortable.
Well, one of our partners have several restaurants in Yokohama Prefecture, so he decided to name it Yokohama Meat Kitchen.
Well, there are a lot of Japanese restaurants in the Philippines, in Manila especially. Yeah. What makes Yokohama different, do you think?
Well, our meat is specifically ordered for this restaurant. So aside from being really high quality, our prices, you cannot see them anywhere else. They're really low.
Yeah.
And of course our sauce. Everyone loves our sauce.
Really?
It releases the taste of the meat.
To understand why diners keep coming back for more, you'll need to try one of Yokohama's signature offerings. And that's exactly what I'm here to do. I'm starting my meal with a Yokohama soup, which is a great dish to start off your dining experience with. It's a clear broth with cabbage, carrots, and the very tender Japanese pork belly putabara. After the tasty soup, it's on to the resto's most popular plate, the Wagyu set. It contains three different kinds of Wagyu: harami, karubi, and gutan.
This is the fun part.
So this is the Wagyu harami. Mm-hmm. This is very soft. For high quality Wagyus, 10 to 30 seconds would be more than enough to cook it.
Oh, thanks for that tip. This is the sauce, right?
Yes.
Sweet about it, but there's nothing added onto it.
No, there's nothing actually.
Wow.
It's just the meat.
Smelting. Wow.
Actually, if you like that, this is actually a higher quality one. Mm. It's the karubi.
Okay. I didn't even put it the sauce, and it's flavorful.
It is, even without
the
sauce.
You don't need the sauce. Oh my gosh, this is so, so good. And it's like one bite. Wow. I'm gonna be looking for this. Justin!
For those who love langua, the Wagyu tongue is something you absolutely have to try.
It's a bit of a bite, though.
Mm-hmm. It just wants to stay in my mouth longer. We're kissing, you know. Wow. Not what I expected. It doesn't... I mean, the only thing I know that I've eaten as strong as langua.
Yeah,
it has a lot of... it's been, you know, cooked for hours.
Yeah.
In sauce, but this one's... just grilled. Wow.
Another meaty treat to try out is the yakisuki, a combination of yakiniku and sukiyaki. These thinly sliced of grilled sukiyaki beef is best enjoyed after you've dipped it in scrambled raw eggs so you can get all the best flavors. And if you think Yokohama Meat Kitchen is all about beef, here's a pork treat that's a pleasant surprise, a homemade Vienna sausage.
Your favorite, let's try this, sausage. And it's homemade. You dip it also in the sauce?
Yes, you can. It pops in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
It's extremely juicy, so I love it.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
All my friends, actually, that's what they like here as well. Especially if I cook it for them.
There's so much flavor in it.
There is.
It's so soft. Different flavors after every bite.
Now, if it's juicy, crispy chicken you're craving for, order the latest addition to the menu, chicken tempura. While these meats are good to have on their own, you can also choose to have it with Japanese potato salad Oreno for a bit of starch. Or with a Yokohama Don, Japanese rice topped with egg, special sweet sauce, and tempura flakes for some added texture. These two add-ons combined with the succulent meats will surely give you one hearty meal. It's easy to see why Yokohama Meat Kitchen has gained a place in the hearts of foodies in the metro. These high-quality meats won't put a hole in your pocket, and they're very tasty to boot.